there's one thing we all love is a greasy and delicious mouth-watering cheeseburger. There's absolutely nothing healthy about a delicious burger, but you're not gonna be more greasy you will accumulate. Since they get all the grease from all the burgers being cooked, at a certain point it just becomes a deep-fried hamburger. And the funny thing is, they never change that grease. So you know it's packed full of flavor and history, which is almost impossible to replicate, but I am going to do my best. And the first thing to do is kick some onions into it. I'm hoping that deep-frying those onions into the grease is gonna give you even better flavor. Now I'm gonna be caramelizing the onions and not burning it. And to do that, I'll be keeping my grease at 325 degrees Fahrenheit. You want it golden brown, but not burned. To make it even more flavorful, I'm gonna be using Worcestershire sauce. We know that sauce was available during that time. I'm thinking that over 100 years of making burgers, some must have gotten in there, so I'll definitely be adding that in. Now let's talk about meat, because that's the most important ingredient. I like to grind my own beef. And the theory of Dyer's restaurant is this: if you have a lean burger patty and you add it to the grease, it will suck it up. But if you have a fattier burger, that won't happen, as its cooking grease will come out. I'm not sure if that's true, but to me that does make sense. So to make my burger blend, I made 25% fat and the rest lean. That should be plenty of fat. The goal is to make 3-ounce balls. If you don't have a scale, just use a measuring cup. As long as the weight is consistent, you're good to go. And once I was done, this is what they look like. Now here's an interesting thing: there will be absolutely no salt on the burgers. It's all gonna come from the mustard, a good amount of pickles, and the cheese. However, they do add a little bit of freshly ground black pepper. But talking about cheese, I'm gonna be using the most popular one there is. Yes, the processed stuff. To me, on a burger, this is as good as it gets. Yes, it is the processed stuff, but it's good. For the bread, I'll be using brioche bun. That's not what's using Dyer's, but I think this will make a way better burger. But now that we have everything ready, I'm gonna be deep frying my burgers at 300 degrees Fahrenheit. And it's 100% about technique. So I say it is enough talking, and it is time to make some amazing burgers. So let's do it.